Hello, everyone. I think my sound is on. Hello, hello, everybody. I'm Nichol. It is Friday, November 18th, 2022, and it is in the afternoon for me. This is one of my later lives. Thank you guys so much for letting me be a little bit later than what I normally do. I'm going to try, as I mentioned a few weeks ago, to do some lives a little bit later in the day for me, which I know works a little bit better for some of you as well. I will continue to kind of have them, I think, at both times, just as time allows. Hello, everybody. So I did see that Linda in the comments before we went live asked how I have time for everything. And so if you're new here, card making is my full-time job. So I very much try to keep that to working hours. Anything I do extra, cross stitch, felt stitching, quilting, that's what I do in my free time. So even though card making is super, super fun and I love it, it is my full-time job. So I do some other things to give me a brain break. Hello, everyone. It's so good to see you guys in the chat today. My son might come home partway through here. I didn't think this through very well when I decided to go live later today. They get out of school a little bit early and then are off for Thanksgiving here in the U.S. So for next week. Yeah, I am in my festive red today. I'm completely in comfy clothes today. It's been a long week. It's been a good week, but just a long weekend. And Ethan is going to help me get the tree out and we're going to decorate and do some things like that. That his gift to me for my birthday is acts of service. And so I told him a few days ago when it was my actual birthday, I was like, we'll just do it later on this weekend. Hello, everybody. If this is your first time here, please give me a thumbs up or a heart in the chat. Let me know. I know I've seen quite a few new people. I love seeing that we have some new people who are able to catch us or watch us live today. Oh, how fun. Grocery shopping and watching me. That's hilarious. Oh, and hello from Sweden. Oh, nice. I love it. Let's see. Well, oh, and let's see. Mary Ann from Denmark. I've seen quite a few from different places all over the world. I love seeing all of that. Oh, thank you so much, Janice. That's so nice of you. So today we're going to have a little fun with some Papertrey ink goodies. I really wanted to do something very non-traditional Christmas, at least non-traditional colors, contrary to how I'm dressed. So we're going to do some pastel rainbow stockings on a card using October release Papertrey product. I know their November release just came out yesterday, I believe. So I will have some projects with some of that coming up soon. And part of the reason, a couple of weeks ago, I went live and did some gingerbread bakery tags, and that set is back in stock. So I'm super excited about that. And I will show you some of the other things I made with October release products. Hello from Scotland and Oregon. Oh my goodness, how awesome. Hello, hello. Adventures with Carissa, Thanksgiving break and watching me live. Oh, thank you. Let's see. Oh, thank you so much. Is it Sirlet? You know, sometimes I don't get things right. So sorry, but thank you so much for your kind comments. The dividers I'm using for my stamps, I actually got from the stamp market. I don't even know if they're still available. If you guys know, let me know in the chat. But that's where the dividers I'm using come from. I've had them for a really, really long time. Okay, if you have questions while we are working through our card, if you put question in all caps, it does help it pop out at me a little bit while we are chatting. And then I know last week I used Olo markers in the demonstration, and I said that I thought I'd have Lori Craig come on and she will talk about the Olo markers because she works for them. She knows all of the good details and can answer all of your questions. And I believe that is going to be December 2nd. I do think it will be a 1 p.m. Central Time live She and I went to dinner last night and kind of visited about it. That is our plan. I will let you know in the community. I will let you know on social. But I'm super excited to have her join me and kind of be able to just tell everybody all the things about those markers. So stay tuned for that. Ethan's here. And I guess that's all I've got for you today, I think. So, oh, and I won't be live next Friday. I've mentioned that the last couple of weeks. It'll be the day after Thanksgiving. And so just to give everybody in the U.S. time with your families or to do whatever it is you're going to do, maybe you're decorating, maybe you're shopping, whatever, we just won't be live next week. So the next live will be December 2nd. Let's see. Mindy, you missed nothing. I literally just popped on. So, oh, what markers? The Olo markers, the alcohol ink markers. Okay, you guys, I am going to flip the camera around and I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the projects I've done with the Papertrey October release. I know we're mid-November, but I'm still working through new things. This is what we're going to make today. It's repeating stockings. I'm using Simon Says Stamp, Pawsitively saturated inks. And I just really wanted to create something a little bit different. And it was really, really fun. So we're going to be doing that. And then we're even going to stamp a little coordinating envelope. Let's see. Nancy says she loves her Olo markers. That's awesome. This card and little ornament like tag is actually something I did in my Patreon last week. So that video is exclusive to Patreon members. It was a live. And this is using some of the gardenia dyes and also some other things from the October release, but I wanted to show them here. Really, really fun. There was a lot of good stuff in that October release. And then this was the rustic little star card. This is some mica stain. I think I've probably shown this one before. Really, really cute. And then this is the tags, the gingerbread tags that we made in a live a couple of weeks ago. And really fun. This is the set that everybody was asking when it was going to be back, and it is back in stock now. And imagine, if you will, these tags in like some of these colors. How cute would that be? So maybe you want to do pinks and reds or aquas and pinks or something. I think it would be really fun. Anyway, I just wanted to mention that that gingerbread bakery is back in stock. Oh man, I just spilled all those. I knew I was going to. I have a bunch of things pre-die cut and I just spilled it all. Fantastic. It's like if you leave gems or embossing powder open, you know you're going to spill it. At least that's my philosophy, I swear. Okay. Let me see. I am going to go ahead and we're going to do our background. This background is all actually a stencil set from Papertrey Ink. I'm only going to use one of them. You can use them, I think, together if you want, but I'm just going to use this one. Let's see. And I am going to grab a background. What we're going to do is we're going to lightly ink our background with some Tide Pool ink just to give a little pattern. I know it's super subtle, but I'm a big fan of something going on in the background, even if it's not super prominent. And then we're going to use a little Salvage Patina Distress Stain to give even more distressing and splatter to that background. So let's do that so our background can dry while we stamp our images. Hello! Tabitha, is it out of stock at Simon Says Stamp? I got the notification this morning that said it was in stock. Make sure you click on the actual product, even if it says out of stock. Sometimes, and you know, it could have gone out of stock again. It came back in stock yesterday. So I am going to just very lightly, I'm not actually going to come in from the edges, but I am going to Very lightly take Tide Pool and ink up the center of this, leaving the edges white. Well, darn, it's already out, huh? Is it out of stock on the Papertrey site as well? I know a lot of people's probably signed up for notifications. And it's exactly, well, not, I mean, I've already done a live with that, so I wouldn't do another one, but that's why I'm not doing a live with that one or another video with that, since it seems to be popular right now. Okay, so I love leaving the edges kind of that faded color, and I'm just going to pop it into this clear plastic box, and we're going to take some of the Salvage Patina Distress Stain. Yeah, we all still spill things. I do, but I swear, I mean, I've moved it around my desk so much. Shannon says, well, hi. Yeah, I'm actually making cards today, though, Shannon. No cross stitch. And I'm just going to slightly press down the Salvage Patina and make splatters all over this. I really want it to be kind of messy and distressy. Is that even a word? Probably not. But I love how it ends up looking. So really tone on tone, nice and light, and it's going to set off our pastel stockings perfectly. Let's see. Flick69, there won't be a UK vendor for the Simon Says Stamp ink since they are Simon branded inks. They're only available at Simon Says Stamp. Okay, I'm going to set my background aside to completely dry. And hello, everybody just coming in. Awesome. Messy and distressed, Susie said. Yes, absolutely. So I have just got some little, like, quarter sheets. It's card front-sized sheets of Nina Smooth White cardstock. And we're going to start stamping. We're going to start stamping our stockings first. I need to look. I can't remember which ones. I didn't do all of them off camera, but I also didn't want to do all of them on camera because the sample die cutting took a while. The stamping doesn't take so long, but definitely the die cutting does. Shannon goes, I like paper crafts too. Oh, thank you. Liz, I already got a glimmer machine, but thank you. Yes, my glimmer machine died last week. It was real sad. I've had it for a long time, though, so, you know, it's okay. I had the OG one. I think the very first one they ever came out with. Let's see. Well, hello, Kate from Florida. Oh, thank you, Wendy. That's so nice. Okay, so I think I'm just going to start. What I'm going to do is with this half sheet, I'm going to position my stamp in a corner because I can stamp it. And without moving this, I'm going to flip my paper and stamp another one. And then I'll flip it over so I can use the opposite corners. I do that a lot when I need multiples of something. So we're going to start with a little cheeky ink. And I don't have all of the ink colors out that I used. I have a lot, but I was trying to keep my work surface as clean as possible because it was a lot of inks. And I am going to stamp my light color. And we're actually going to go through and we're going to stamp our base of the stockings first. Yep, and I did. Just because I can see we're still talking about the Spellbinders Glimmer, I did get mine at Hobby Lobby because I needed it right away. I needed it for something. And so I ran to Hobby Lobby and got it. And I thought it was a pretty reasonable reason. I thought it was pretty reasonably priced. I can't even talk. So now I'm going to do some melon for my orange stocking. And I did use, so I will say some of the things I stamped for this, and here's our stamp set, by the way. It's Sweet Stockings. I forgot to mention it. Lots of awesome layering, lots of cute little pieces, as you can see in the finished card that you can fill your stockings with. I stamped some of these things just with an acrylic block. I don't always do that. The stockings is a little bigger, and in case I needed to stamp it more than once, I went ahead and used my Misty. So I'm going to flip it over now because this corner doesn't have anything, and we're just going to stamp those last two stockings that I need on the back side. And we need, let's do a seafoam one. Judy said she just ordered this stamp set. Well, that's awesome. You're going to be all set. I've seen some cute card examples where people have either made or found a fireplace die of some sort and made a little fireplace scene, which I thought was really, really cute. And then I think Tide Pool, which is the color we used for the background. With this many colors of ink, I gotta really think. All right. See. Colleen says, just ordered this stamp and die set and remembered to use. Oh, well, thank you. That was so nice of you. All right. The next thing I did is I'm taking this little piece that has like the cuff and the toe and the heel, and I am going to stamp this on every single one of these. And because we're lining it up with the stocking, what is going to end up happening, and if you were doing all of these, like when I did all eight, this is what I did, you're not having to move your stamp if you're using your Misty, because it's going to be in the same position in every corner. I just used two little quarter sheets of paper when I made the original card sample. I don't think that's lined up very good. You just got to have to get it lined up that first time. And then you should be good to go. So this one, I'm going to take some Tropic ink. And we're going to stamp that little bit darker. I'm just doing tone on tone for all of these. I think you could definitely mix and match and get some fun, more colorful effects. I can't remember the name of the snowflake stencil. I'm sorry, I don't have it in front of me. I will add it when we're done. For the aqua, I'm going to use Surf as the darker color. It's called something snowflake. I probably forgot to add it in the supplies. I'm so sorry. I know I did. It should be in the October release stuff or in the newest. If you click on the newest stuff, it will be one of the newer sets from Papertrey. I'm sorry, you guys. Of course, I forgot. We're going to use blush here. Yes, Emma says Hero Arts has a Stampin' Cup fireplace. That's the one I was thinking of. That would be really cute. So we're going to do that, and then we'll just move to our last one. And, oh, I took it off. What in the world? Not being smart. Okay, and we're going to take some cantaloupe. All right. Now we can remove this. Geometric snowflakes. Larissa, thank you for helping me. There were two different snowflake sets and I could not remember the name of it to save my life. Geometric snowflakes, everybody, if you're wondering about that stencil. Thank you so much, Larissa. Okay. Next, there are lots of ways to decorate your stockings. So we have this fun little like partial design, which I'm going to do on one of them. There's some polka dots. There's this fun little stripe and polka dot that's horizontal. We have a vertical. And then, of course, we have stripes. And the only one I ended up not using was the lights but it's really cute. And I don't know if you can see, there's even the little piece where you can stamp the lights over the top. So if you were doing a light enough stocking, I think it would be really cute to add those little strings of lights over that. So for our orange stocking, we're going to do the horizontal stripes. Let's see. And we're going, honestly, it's pretty easy to line up. Now, if you were going to stamp all of them exactly the same, you could do exactly what I did for the other layering. Place it one time and then just flip around and stamp all of them. But because I wanted my stockings to all have a little bit different pattern, there's some repeating. I actually did not mean to do a stripe and a stripe, but you know, that's how it ended up. So that's okay. I didn't notice it till just now, so I think it'll be all right. I'm going to take that darker of the two colors. So again, this is going to be the cantaloupe, and we're just going to stamp the fun little pattern. Super easy. Yes, Flick69 says, I love the lights in the other top layering. Yes, they're so cute. All right. And then we're going to do a little polka dot here, the big polka dot, I guess I should say, for our blush colored stocking. With our blush ink, Larissa said, you're gonna make me need this set. Well, maybe you have something similar that you can create with too. Oh, that's cute. Deborah says you could use those lights on a little character like he's wrapped in lights. That would be darling. That would be really cute. And then we're going to flip it over. And on our aqua, this is where we're going to use just this little partial piece, kind of like the little cuff up here. And I'm going to use my surf ink. And then the final one I'm going to do during the live here is the stripes, and we're going to do those in our tropic color. And I really like the stripes. We're just going to get that lined up. There we go. And we're going to use Tropic for that one. And there are our stockings. So I'm going to set this one aside for just a minute. Oh, thank you, Flick69. She says the colors are gorgeous. They really are pretty and happy. Monique, these were very easy to line up. And I'm going to tell you the truth because here's my real talk for the day. Some stamps are super hard to line up. Not my favorite. I won't use them live. The whole reason I did this card ahead of time was because I was not going to do these live if they didn't line up. Because I wanted to be able to tell you or show you in real time. Yes, they line up okay. No, they don't. A lot of times I won't use layering stamps if I can't get them to line up. So they have to be able to line up for me to use them because it has to be user-friendly or dum-dum-friendly. I don't know, you guys. Some people are so good at it. I'm not. So it has to be easy. These are really easy to line up. Oh, Janice, thank you. That's so nice. Let's see. Oh, Tabitha, that's okay. The replay will be here for you. Go do your meeting. And who knows, if it isn't very long, we might still be here. Okay, so I have lots of little pieces to stamp. And as I mentioned, and I'm going to show you, bring the card back in. I repeated a lot of things. Like, I wanted all my stockings to be full and have lots and lots of greenery. So I'm going to stamp one of these things. Just know that off camera, I stamped a lot of them and die cut them so that we wouldn't be here all day. We're going to have lots of little poinsettia flowers, candy canes, greenery, gingerbread men, all of that good stuff. And then I only did one of the little cardinal. And I would say out of everything on here, that's the only thing that was slightly tricky to line up. And once I figured it out, it was easy. And I'll show you that. So let's go ahead and do everything on here. I'm just going to do one little candy cane. There's nothing to line up for this guy. Oh, thank you, Sherry. Thank you so much, Marlene. So I decided I didn't want to go with the traditional bright, bright red. So we're going to use watermelon for the candy cane. I did do one, I think, in carnation, pardon me. So there's going to be a pink candy. Yeah, I have one little pink candy cane in one of the stockings. But I did a lot of red, and then I just kind of mixed it up. So we've got our candy cane. And I guess I'll just go image by image. We'll do our first, this one is a layering greenery piece. And this one is going to be this little branch with the red berries, and it lines up so easy. So let's stamp it in field color ink first. I did use Field, Sprout, and Fairway for all of the little greenery pieces. And then we're going to take the little berries, which is this right here. Judy, I used the dies. These were too little, I felt like, for the scan and cut, or too detailed. I mean, it may have worked, but no, I used the dies. I used the dies to die cut all of these. And then we're going to take our watermelon ink again and just stamp those little berries on there. Isn't that so cute? I don't know why I liked this one so much, but I really did. Okay, and then let's go ahead and do our other two greenery pieces. This one I'm going to stamp in Sprout. Adventures with Carissa says, those little stamps would be pretty to create your own background. Yes, that is a great idea. I'm going to stamp that twice. So that is the Sprout color. Normally, I'd probably clean these a little better, but we're going to go for time today. Yes, Sherry said she loves how Simon says stamps inks are sold in trios so that they go together. Me too. And then this one that looks like little holly leaves, I'm going to stamp in the fairway color. So you can really kind of see those three shades, how they, this is light, medium, and dark. All right, let's go ahead and stamp our little bird. So I know I said that my red on my card, I was using watermelon. I did choose for the little tiny bird to stamp it in cherry. And I'm also going to use this little acrylic block. Janice, I love my scan and cut. It really just kind of depends. I think you're still going to need to have a die cutting machine because standalone dies, obviously, and things like that. It just depends, I guess. I use mine mainly for when I don't have the coordinating dies. So I'm going to stamp my bird with cherry ink, which is going to give me a much darker color. I really wanted it, because I was only using one, to stand out. And then for the beak, and it is so teeny tiny, you guys. It's this little piece. It looks like a smudge, but I have it here on my acrylic block, and I really hope I stamp it the right direction. I'm going to use woodsy ink, and there's just no way I'm going to There we go. No way I'm using my Misty for that. I know it's really tiny. You could probably draw it in with a pen and it would be easier. But that's okay. I use the stamp. I would say that was the most challenging part of this card, was that little teeny tiny beak. Karen says once she got her scan and cut, she rarely buys dies. And I've heard that a lot. For me, it's mostly when I don't have the dies yet. And it helped me a lot, just, for example, during Stamptember and things like that. So our little poinsettia flower, I'm going to stamp in watermelon. And yes, Adventures with Carissa is asking about Black Friday sales. I do believe there will be some. And I'm going to use the woodsy colored ink to stamp the little inside of the flower. And again, I'm just going to use an acrylic block for that and not worry about trying to line it up in my Misty. All right, let me look and see. I know we have our gingerbread man. And I think that's all I'm going to, that's everything. It feels like there should be more, but it's because I stamped most of it already. So for the last one, I'm going to use some cappuccino ink and we're going to stamp this little gingerbread man. Marie says, no, not an oddball. You just prefer the dies. Maybe. She says she has the scan and cut, but she buys more dies. I will say if it bothers you to not have the super clean edge that dies provide, let me see if I have a card. I do. Let me grab it. Since you're asking about it, I'm going to give you an example, and I don't think it doesn't bother me, but I know that it bothers some people. So this is my card using the exclusive for Art Impressions and Simon Says Stamp. I die cut this with the Scan and Cut. And while it looks really good, like around all of this, it's not going to cut right in here like maybe a die would. And around the hand is where you can see it the most. Again, it doesn't bother me, but it might bother some people. So there's a little example of that Scan and Cut. Question unrelated, what bolts do you use for your fabric? If you check my most recent Floss2 video, I have links to that. Okay, we're going to grab our coordinating dies, and I am going to die cut these. I'm going to take some of the low tack tape. Lisa said, I cut felt with my die, so I've collected many. Yes, very fun. So I am just going to take my little dies, and this is the low tack tape from Simon Says Stamp, and we're going to line them up and run them through our die cutting machine. And my goal, with the exception of the stockings, because I'm going to need to reuse that die multiple times, which is where the scan and cut probably would have come in handy, I'm going to try to do them with one pass. Oh, yay! Adventures with Chris has said that her and her mom got the entire collection of mica stains. They are my favorite. I absolutely love them. Okay. And sorry about if my phone is making noise in the background. I forgot to silence it. Okay, so I know it's excessive. I usually reuse my tape. Let's see. You're welcome, Melody. I do like that these cut pretty close as well. Oh, and you know what? I forgot one thing to mention. I didn't stamp it on camera, but the Little Merry Christmas is also from this set. So every image on this card comes from one stamp set. I kept trying to make something else work. Like I almost felt like from Mean Girls, you know, stop trying to make fetch happen. Yeah, that's how I felt. Because it nothing was working. And I was like, stop trying to make other things work. Because I did not want to cover up all of the pretty stockings. I use Post-it tape for die cutting a lot, too. Let's see. But today I'm using this. All right. Let's get my die cutting machine. Well, hi, Sandy. Sometimes those appointments do run long, unfortunately, don't they? Nancy, are you asking if the silhouette will die cut? I know that it will. I just know that it's detailed and I don't know how to do it. And this is sad to admit because I used to use my silhouette machine daily back in the scrapbooking days. I'm pretty sure my silhouette is in the basement, and B, I have not used it in over a year. I can't even believe that. But I've heard from some that it's a little bit more involved. Mean Girls, yes. And We Wear Pink on Wednesdays, exactly. Oh, I love my little mini machine. The only reason I didn't get it out today was because I used these bigger pieces of paper. And I didn't want to prep smaller pieces. I'd already prepped these and I thought, oh, well, we're just going to use... We'll just get out the platinum. It's not too terrible big. Let's see. Hard. It looks like it might be kind of hard to work on the silhouette. Yes! Oh, that would be great, Judy. I would love if you'd let us know during the next live how it works with your Scan and Cut. I don't keep my Scan and Cut out all the time, or I would have tried it. After I did that Art Impressions card, I put it away. I will say that might be one of the downsides of that machine. If you don't have tons of room to leave it out, if you have to get it out every time, and that's the same thing for my silhouette. Because I was having to put it away, I tend to not use it. But I think if you have room to set it out, maybe you'd use it more. See how our background looks. I think it's all dry. Look how fun. Wouldn't this be fun in lots of different colors? I always want to make like lots of backgrounds in all of the colors. Take the distress stains and spritz them. Mica stain would be pretty as well. I chose not to do anything shimmery, but I think it would be very, very cute in a shimmery color. Let's grab our stockings and all of my little pieces. It is a big machine. And Karen says she has hers on a workstation, but it's in an area for easy access. Definitely. I think you would definitely have to have some easy access. I'm basically going to just kind of copy what I did here for those to put this together. So I'm just going to pull out the pieces for my stocking. And I have some tweezers handy. And what I did is, well, you want your glue to be working. So let's try to unclog it. Yes, backgrounds in all of the colors. Oh, that would be fun. Bree said she's hoping to sew some stockings. That would be very, very fun. So I just put a little glue right there at the top. And then I want to kind of build build out my stocking, I guess, if you will. Almost like imagining that you're filling the stocking. That's how I think of it. And just building it up, adding all the cute little things inside. And it's okay if you don't have quite enough glue. In fact, I would probably recommend starting with a little bit. And then I like to take my tweezers. Oops, I missed. Come back. And we're just going to kind of pinch it, clamp it down. That's what I always call clamping it down. Oh, thank you, Marlene. It's funny you mentioned that Christmas tree card with all the bright colors. This card was inspired by that, for sure. In fact, I thought about doing a slimline with these, but then I thought, well, let's try it with a standard A2 size card. So I love that you noticed that. That's so fun. I'm going to take some foam squares now, and we are going to... And I might notice I put those right over where all of those kind of met. We're going to pop our stockings up. I like to have things popped up a little bit. Did I even get that in there? Yeah. So I'm going to use a combination of small and big. Adventures with Carissa, my set day is Friday. And usually what I had been doing or have been doing for about the last year is I go live at 9 a.m. Central Time. But I, a few weeks ago, needed to move that. And I did 1 p.m. Central, and I had a really good feedback. So I probably am going to do both, like twice a month I'll do 9, twice a month I will do 1, and I need to figure out a set schedule for 2023, but it will be on Fridays, and I will let you know on my community page. Monique, I am so impressed all your Christmas cards are done. That is awesome. Bye, Flick69. Thanks for joining us. So I'm just going to continue to do the same thing. And this card did go together pretty quickly. I mean, I know it's a lot of little pieces, but pretty, pretty speedy once you kind of get it down. And I just found it fun to kind of fill all of them a little bit different. While that's drying, let's grab our orange one, which I didn't die cut the best, but that's all right. 2023 seems so far away. Brie, I wish I felt that way. I don't, because for work, we're already working well into 2023. Monique, it was a hot summer here in Holland. For the reason you have your Christmas cards done right. I love it. That's funny. Yeah, definitely want to stay inside then. It's been so cold here. I know I saw in the chat here before we went live, a lot of you mentioned that it was cold where you are. Okay, that's not staying. Maybe I need my other set of tweezers. Let me see. This is why you have lots of tweezers. Lots and lots. Clamp all the things. Oh, good, Kim. Yes, that's exactly why I'm going to try to do a few that are a little bit later, because I know a lot of people, a lot of my viewers here from the West Coast, it was so early for you guys. And I know that that does make it later than for East Coast. So I'm trying to figure out the right balance. All right. Oh, it's snowing in Toronto. We had a little snow earlier this week. Oh man, Sandy. Sandy was all gonna come in with how nice it is. Hot said it's a high of 67, and that sounds so beautiful. Yes, and Carolyn's in California. Oh, she's from California, but Texas heat is no joke. Yes. When I'm lining these up, I really just eyeballed it. But what I did try to do, whoops, is to line up that kind of cuff like so. And then I'm going to add a little dab of glue and let's find a little flower. So cute. Decorating these was my favorite part, which I'm sure doesn't surprise anyone. Filling them all up. Loves cold, snowy winters. It's snowy and 30 here, Patty says, and she says, yuck. Yes. Think I like it better like that. And I kind of secure everything with that foam adhesive square. Kind of smash it all together. I use a little liquid glue to kind of get it, somewhat secure. And then I just mash it all together with the foam square. I haven't made Christmas cards. I'm probably not going to. I mean, I make a lot of cards here on my channel. So I usually just send out a bunch of random. I don't make all of one style or anything like that. Molly says, question, would those clips you use on your roll up cross stitch material be good to hold things while they are dry, or do they apply too much pressure? I don't think they probably apply enough pressure. They're pretty lightweight. They're actually kind of used for quilting and stuff. Tweezers are going to be much stronger. Oh my gosh, Creative Cindy, you got 15 inches of snow yesterday. Holy cow, that is a lot of snow. Now I need to know where you're from. That's a lot of snow. Let's see, I need a gingerbread man and a candy cane. And they're all flipped the wrong direction. Okay, so the glue has already dried here. This is a good little tip, but I really forgot to stick my gingerbread man down. So we're gonna do a little surgery, a little corrective surgery. No one will know. We're just gonna snip him in half. I'm gonna put a little glue. And we're going to just slide him underneath the edge. There we go. That'll work. Sometimes when I forget. Adventures with Carissa says, please send some snow to California. Someone get right on that. I really probably should have prepped some of these off camera. Oh well, I didn't. I didn't, so we're gonna just be adding our foam squares now. Hidden half-eaten gingerbread boy, Teresa said. I love that. That's funny. Yes, that's exactly what it is. Santa took a bite out of him and then stuck him back in the stocking. Oh, I just love them all lined up like that. They look so, so pretty. I'm just going to go ahead. This is my little sentiment, and it does have a little coordinating die that comes in the set, which is so super cute. We're going to just pop that right there on our stocking. We'll get a heart in a little bit. send me to California, Patty said. Oh, I love it, you guys. That's so funny. Oh my gosh, Rhonda, that's a great idea. She says, I made myself a rule to make 8 Christmas cards a month, and they are all done by Christmas. That is a really great tip. Thank you for sharing that. So this one, I think I did all kinds of greenery. I'm going to do all of the little pieces. All of them. Let's see. Marlene says, that just means we get to spend more time with you. Foam adhesive away. Well, thank you. What is everyone's plans for the weekend? I love hearing what everyone's up to. Oh, I'm going to be a gluey mess. Goodness, I'm making a huge mess. Tell me what you're going to do, if you have fun plans, or if you're going to craft. All the things. Oh, that's Sherry has her scan and cut and something else on a cart with rolling wheels, and that's awesome. I like that. That's a great idea. Kind of saves some space. You can just roll it out when you need it. Creative Cindy says, do you know how to access the community page on an iPad or iPhone? I feel like I do, but I would have to do it. I don't know off the top of my head. Does anyone know off the top of your head how to access the community page when you're visiting someone's YouTube channel? I have to do it, unfortunately, to know how to do it. It isn't super user-friendly. I would agree with that. Oh, Teresa's going to help daughter move and craft if possible. Cleaning up craft room, Catherine says. Need to start Christmas cards, Melody says, but just wants to cross-stitch instead. Yes. You have a 13-year-old. Awesome, Jessica. Oh, Holly's going to craft with friends. That sounds amazing. I am working on Valentine's Day 2023. That's funny. I mean, there's still some holiday things, but yep, that is just the nature of the beast. It, you know, moves ahead. Did I lose some pieces or did I miscount? I better look and see what we've got here. I feel like I didn't stamp something I was supposed to. Well, we can always just stamp another one. That's fine. You guys might get lots of extra time today if I miscounted how many things I need. High school marching band state final in Arizona for grandson. Oh, that sounds amazing. Christmas lights this weekend. Oh, hubby needs help with the Christmas lights. That's funny. And you're the helper. I love it. Danielle says, working plague mom taxi cab. Yes. Oh, nice. Janice has a full weekend planned. Yep. Me and the boy, we're going to... Well, I say that. It's mostly going to be me. He's the muscle that carries all of the things. We're going to get Christmas stuff out, I think. I also need to go do my final grocery shopping for Thanksgiving. Larissa is crafting and cleaning for all. Yes, exactly. That's going to be me this weekend. I have a lot of that to do as well. Let's go ahead and add some of our flowers. And also our cardinal. I don't want to forget. It's a lot of little pieces, but I just love it. I feel like all these little pieces are what makes this. see. Thanksgiving shopping tomorrow and meal planning for next week. Oh, yes, I am hosting as well. But I said we're just going to kind of be low-key-ish. Not going to stress about it too much. That's my goal anyway. We will see. Let's see. Oh, yay! Jennifer, that sounds amazing. Awesome. Yeah, those ornaments were super fun to make last year. I had a good time with those wood slice ornaments. Can impress scan and cut too? No, it cannot. Let's see. Oh, Brie, I love stuffing is my absolute favorite thing on Thanksgiving. I'm with you there. Absolute favorite, favorite, favorite. And I think it's like a lot of my family's favorite too. I'm hungry just thinking about it. Janice, my goal is to not burn my son's house down. Oh my gosh, that's so funny. You're welcome, Teresa. Cassie said, staying in from the cold, windy weather, watching college football and stitching. Nice. Yeah, I want to stitch all the felt things. Honestly, there's just not enough hours in the day for all the things I want to do. Everyone else feel that way too? I have all of these ideas. What I really need to do is make like a master list of ideas so that I don't forget. And hopefully maybe I could start working on some of them. Oh gosh. Come back here, little piece. Let's go ahead and secure that. Yes, exactly, Janie. Oh, I love that. Roberta says chicken enchiladas are Thanksgiving dish. You know, we're not having turkey. No one really likes it all that much. So I feel that. I know that that's some people really, really love it and some people don't. I don't mind turkey. So I do want to preface that. But my family, it's not their favorite. So we are not. I decided, instead of having a bunch of turkey that we ended up not eating and then I froze and then it didn't get eaten then either, I'm not making it this year. So nope, we're not having turkey. Let's see. It is fun to do, though. I agree. It is fun. I love turkey, Marie says. Yes, I know. It isn't that I don't like it. It's really my family doesn't like it. I don't know. Maybe they're all weird. My dad does. I'm sure my mom's making it, but we're not. My parents live in Arizona and we're not going. So, but I'm sure my mom does the best Thanksgiving. The best. I really didn't count good. I'm just going to go out on a limb there. I am missing lots of pieces from my original card. Not that it matters that much. I'm wondering if when I spilled everything, do you guys remember if you were here for this live, I lost the top of this. Oh yeah, I found it the next day when I cleaned up my work desk. Probably the same thing here. Let me see. This one does not have near enough stuff in it. So here's what we're gonna do. Let's stamp our envelope, and then I'm going to stamp an extra little greenery piece. Patty says turkey is too dry. I think that's a lot of what it is. Yep. Let's see. Where's my magnet? So I have this white envelope, and I'm going to put it in my Misty. And I decided to do my little stocking kind of right here so that I leave enough room to write the address and all of that good stuff. And we're going to grab our Tide Pool and Tropic Colors. So let's do Tide Pool first. And we're going to build our stocking, and then I'm going to show you how I'll show you that envelope again. How I did that, because it's really fast and easy. I wanted it to be easy. With whenever I do envelopes, I don't want them to be super difficult with lots and lots of steps. More than likely, the recipient's not going to keep it. So, and it gets, you know, dirty and things in the mail. So we're just going to do the exact same thing for the stocking part that we did for the stockings on the card. Let's see. And then we are going to just take something to mask. It can be a post-it note. It can be post-it tape. I'm just going to use this little low-tack tape and place it right there. And what we're going to do is fill our stocking with just the greenery. I found this worked really easily and it looks really cute. Rebecca, leftovers are my favorite part too. Truly, is there anything better? I love leftover turkey sandwiches. Yeah, I don't know. I love it. I really do like leftovers. Almost better than the actual meal. Okay, and then there's our next little dark, or our greenery piece, pardon me. Let's grab the little berries for that little pop of red. Isn't it looking cute? Just a really fun way to make a coordinating envelope. And then we're going to take some fairway ink for our final little greenery piece. And I'm kind of glad I used the Misty because that needed stamped more than once. We're going to keep that out. And look at that! So cute! Okay, then the final thing I did was I did take the Merry and Bright. We can just use the Misty for that. This, I guess. I just took an acrylic block, but oh, I bet I put my black ink away. Well, I better go get it. Okay, let me grab my ink. And then I did just add that little Merry and Bright. Oh my gosh. To my stocking. And I totally dropped my ink pad on everything. Well, it wouldn't be alive without me making some sort of a mess. But there is our coordinating little envelope. Okay, I am going to take this and this, and we're just going to stamp one more of these really quick. I think we can get by with just that. Let me see. Nancy says her favorite part of Thanksgiving is the sandwiches the next day. I see there's a lot of comments on turkeys. Yep. I have heard that deep fried turkeys are good. I don't know that I've ever had one. It sounds good. Okay, let me grab my card. Because this one I felt like didn't have, I misjudged. It just needs a little more greenery. So I'm going to put a foam square on the back. We're just going to give it a little surgery so we can tuck it in. Oh, much, much better. Okay, then I'm going to add a little glue. Let's see, just shows you. Yes, oh, I'm human. I dropped an ink pad right on the floor the other day. Of course, the wrong direction. Oh, Nancy, let's get your son with my son and let's teach him how to do the turkey so he can be in charge every year. I like that idea. I like the idea of someone else being in charge of it. My favorite thing to make is the sides, so that's probably part of it. All right. I could actually do without the main dish altogether and just eat sides. Everybody still want to be my friend. I don't know if I should agree, if I should even admit that. Let's see. Okay, and that is it. I do need to put this on a card base, which I'll do in a little bit, but I literally added just one little heart. Looks like that other heart was trying to hitch a ride. Super easy. It's just a lot of little pieces, but look how cute. I mean, all of that layering, all of that coloring, so much fun. Question on your Misty by, I missed it. Can you ask the question again? Let me see. I can try to scroll back. Hold on. Oh, what do you keep in your Misty to have? I use the paper from the pad and now need more cushion to stamp the images. I just use paper from that pad, Carissa. I don't use anything extra special. In fact, this is just the back of, it got flipped over. Let me make, of course my screen is not correct now. And I reuse mine over and over and over. So I have my insert in here. It looks like my Misty needs cleaned badly. But that's all I use. If you need to, you could probably put another sheet or two of paper in. Thank you so much, Carolyn. That's so nice of you. Oh, thank you guys. Thank you. Right, let me flip this around. Okay, everybody. Well, thank you guys so much for joining me today. If I missed any questions, can you please let me know here real quick? I'll hang out. Oh, question. How do we hear about a new release? Do we sign up somewhere? No, like what new release are you asking about just in general? I don't do things for everyone. I wish I could, but I don't. So I will do new releases for Simon Says Stamp. I will always do new release videos and things like that. And it just really depends. But yeah, you can always sign up for my email list and you'll get emails whenever I share new projects and things like that. And you can subscribe to this channel so you're notified when I'm going to go live, when I have a new edited video and all of that good stuff. Any new release, Janie says. Yeah, I don't have a master list for every new release. Most companies have certain days that they go live. I don't even know. I don't even know all of them. So, I could tell you some of them, but I don't know the release day for everything. Holly says, what are the bolts you use for fabric and what was the stamp release you mentioned on Floss 2 from last week? It was related to stamp timber. I don't know, and the bolts are listed on that last Floss 2 video. I will have to go back to the video and think about the stamp timber thing. Let me see. I will be making more Christmas cards and tags. Yes, and thank you. That's a really good suggestion. Roberta says sign up for companies' emails. Yes. So if you have a favorite manufacturer, for example, like we use Papertrey today, sign up for their newsletter because you will get emails from them in right in your inbox, and that should let you know. Thank you. That's a perfect answer. Yep, Lynn says the same thing. Kathy says, can you show more of the new Hero Arts compact cutter? Yes, I can. Absolutely. I would be happy to. I plan to use it for my Hero Arts videos. Their release is the first Monday of every month, unless that Monday is a holiday. Oh, yeah, Holly, no, it was the Art Impressions. Art Impressions didn't do stamp timber this year, but they always do a Christmas release, and that went up today. So, yes, thank you for reminding me. A lot of people follow Art Impressions, and this is the card today. It's on my channel, and are huge, huge fans of it. Not everyone, but I know a lot of people are. A lot of people wondered, you know, where their stamp timber set was. But they do a Christmas release exclusive with Simon Says Stamp every year. And so that's kind of a big thing. And for anyone who's a big fan. Let's see. Carolyn, what company do you use to make personal stamps? I don't have a company to do that. If it's just the stamp on the back of my envelopes, which is my address stamp. I want to say Simply Stamp. I can't remember. I would have to look and try to look back and see where I got those. Any other personalized stamp I have was a gift, and it's not something that you can purchase. But Teresa says she used the Magnuson from Unity Stamps, if that helps. Okay, if I missed anything, drop me a comment down below. Let me know. I hope everyone here in the U.S. has a very happy Thanksgiving. I hope everyone has a great weekend. You get to do something that you want to do, and have a wonderful week next week. Remember, I won't be here live, but I will be here the next week. Definitely check my community page. Sign up. Or subscribe, not sign up. Subscribe to my channel. That way you get notified when I post anything, because I will be letting you know and letting you know for sure that we're going to do the Olo demonstration December 2nd. Okay, everyone. Thank you so, so much. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you later.
The supplies used in today's video are listed and linked below the video here on YouTube. Here is another project that you might be interested in. Please remember to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell to never miss a new live video. Thank you so much for joining me today, and we'll catch you next time.